The distinctive high-pitched whine of a two-stroke motorcycle engine has been music to enthusiasts' ears for generations. These engines, known for their impressive power-to-weight ratio and mechanical simplicity, have powered everything from dirt bikes to racing machines. But in recent years, rumors about their imminent ban have spread throughout the riding community like wildfire. Are two-stroke engines really headed for extinction? The truth is more complicated than the headlines suggest. While not completely banned, these engines face mounting restrictions due to environmental concerns, sparking a heated debate between environmental protection and preserving a beloved part of motorcycle heritage. If you've ever watched a motocross race or passed a dirt bike on a trail, chances are you've encountered that unmistakable sound and smell of a two-stroke engine. Something about that sharp, buzzing whine, coupled with a sweet, acrid scent of partially burned oil, ignites the imagination. But what makes these engines so special and controversial? Well, the answer lies in their revolutionary design. Unlike four-stroke engines, which require four piston movements, down, up, down, up, to complete one power cycle, the two-stroke engine completes a full cycle in just two movements, down, up. This seemingly small difference creates a profound impact. It delivers power with every revolution of the crankshaft, rather than every other revolution. This ingenious design produces what riders often describe as explosive power delivery. The sensation is unmistakable. One moment cruising steadily, the next hurtling forward with thrilling acceleration. This power characteristic comes from getting twice as many power strokes per number of revolutions compared to a four-stroke engine of similar size. This impressive efficiency made two-stroke engines the dominant choice for motorcycles throughout much of the 20th century. They rolled racing circuits and became incredibly popular for everyday bikes because manufacturers could produce smaller, lighter, and less expensive machines that still delivered heart-pounding performance. Their mechanical simplicity, featuring far fewer moving parts than their four-stroke counterparts, also meant easier maintenance and repairs, further cementing their appeal. If two-stroke engines are so efficient at producing power, the question naturally arises, why do they face increasing restrictions? Well, the answer lies in the very design that makes them so potent. In a traditional two-stroke engine, fuel and oil are mixed together and burned simultaneously. This fundamental aspect of their operation creates two major environmental problems that have become increasingly difficult to ignore. First, a significant portion of this mixture, sometimes up to 30%, escapes unburned through the exhaust. Second, burning oil along with fuel produces substantially higher levels of pollutants compared to four-stroke engines. The emissions data tells a sobering story. A single older two-stroke motorcycle can produce the same amount of pollution as 30 to 50 four-stroke cars. Hydrocarbon emissions can be up to 15 times higher than comparable four-stroke engines. Carbon monoxide output ranges from 3 to 10 times higher. Particulate matter emissions reach significantly elevated levels. And perhaps most wastefully, as much as 30% of fuel escapes unburned and is released directly into the environment. Now, these aren't merely abstract numbers on a regulatory document. They translate into real consequences for human health and environmental integrity. Hydrocarbons and nitrogen oxides contribute significantly to smog formation, which aggravates respiratory conditions like asthma. Carbon monoxide reduces oxygen delivery in the bloodstream, posing health risks, particularly in areas with concentrated emissions. Particulate matter penetrates deep into the lungs and can enter the bloodstream, contributing to cardiovascular and respiratory diseases. The environmental impact becomes even more pronounced when two-stroke engines operate in marine environments. When unburned fuel oil mixtures go straight into the water, it creates a toxic effect on aquatic life. Research has documented measurable impacts on fish populations and water quality in areas with heavy two-stroke boat traffic. Even small amounts of these pollutants can disrupt the delicate balance of aquatic ecosystems, affecting everything from microorganisms to apex predators. Two-stroke fanatic or just curious? Please comment. Either way, like and share this video with your riding buddies. Subscribe and click that bell to join our community of gearheads exploring motorcycle technology together. As evidence of environmental harm mounted, governments around the world began taking action. Contrary to popular belief, there isn't a blanket ban on two-stroke engines. Rather, there's a patchwork of regulations that restrict their use in various contexts. The Environmental Protection Agency, also known as the EPA in the United States, has implemented progressively stricter emission standards that many traditional two-stroke engines simply can't meet. The European Union has followed a similar path with its Euro emission standards, each iteration becoming more demanding than the last. Now, these regulatory frameworks don't specifically target two-stroke technology by name, but their emissions thresholds often prove insurmountable barriers for conventional two-stroke designs. California, often at the forefront of environmental regulations in the U.S., has been particularly aggressive through its California Air Resources Board, or CARB. Now, many lakes and waterways in California have completely banned carbureted two-stroke engines on boats, citing water quality concerns and protection of drinking water sources. These regulations emerged after studies revealed that a significant percentage of fuel that escapes unburned into the water can create both surface slicks and dissolved pollutants. The regulatory approach is not driven by arbitrary dislike of the technology, but by evidence-based concerns about public health and environmental protection. Emission standards are established based on extensive research into health impacts, and many traditional two-stroke engines simply can't achieve the necessary reductions in harmful output. These regulations have effectively pushed two-stroke engines out of on-road motorcycles in many developed countries. The familiar street bikes of the 1970s and 1980s, with their distinctive exhaust notes and powerful acceleration, have largely disappeared from legal road use. The regulations have also dramatically reduced two-stroke presence in marine applications and are beginning to impact off-road recreational vehicles as well, creating ripple effects through various motorsports and recreational communities. The motorcycle and marine industries haven't accepted these challenges passively. Facing potential extinction of a technology with some unique advantages, manufacturers have invested in developing new approaches to make two-stroke engines cleaner while preserving their performance characteristics. Direct injection systems represent perhaps the most promising advancement. These systems inject fuel directly into the combustion chamber after the exhaust port closes, preventing the traditional problem of unburned fuel escaping through the exhaust. Companies like BRP Rotax and Orbital Corporation pioneered this technology, demonstrating that two-stroke engines could dramatically reduce their environmental footprint while maintaining their performance edge. Now, the results have been impressive. Modern two-strokes with direct injection can reduce oil consumption by up to 50% and cut unburned fuel emissions by as much as 75% compared to traditional carbureted two-strokes. This transformation challenges the notion that two-stroke technology is inherently dirty and unrefined. Innovation hasn't stopped there. Advanced electronic control systems now optimize fuel delivery with precision that was unimaginable in the carbureted era. Specially designed catalytic converters tackle remaining emissions that do make it into the exhaust stream. Improved combustion chamber designs also ensure more complete burning of the fuel-air mixture. And separate oil injection systems use less oil and mix it more precisely with the fuel, reducing both consumption and emissions. KTM, a major manufacturer of off-road motorcycles, exemplifies this commitment to evolution rather than extinction. Their transfer port injection, or TPI system, has allowed them to continue producing two-stroke dirt bikes that meet Euro 5 emission standards, one of the world's most stringent regulatory frameworks. This achievement proves that with proper engineering investment and innovative thinking, two-stroke technology can adapt to modern environmental requirements. Beyond the technical and environmental aspects, this issue reverberates through motorcycling culture with some profound implications. Two-stroke engines have cultivated a passionate following that spans generations, creating a heritage that many believe deserves preservation despite environmental challenges. The sensory signature of two-stroke engines, that unmistakable exhaust aroma, the high-pitched crescendo that builds from buzz to wail, the responsive power delivery, well, they've all become deeply woven into the fabric of motorcycle culture. These sensations trigger powerful nostalgia and represent a distinct mechanical tradition increasingly rare in an era of homogenized transportation. These engines transcend their mechanical purpose to become cultural artifacts with some significant emotional resonance. Economic factors further complicate the narrative. New four-stroke competition motorcycles typically cost thousands of dollars more than comparable two-stroke models. The maintenance economics similarly favor two-strokes, with their simpler mechanical design allowing repairs at a fraction of four-stroke maintenance costs. A complete top-end rebuild on a two-stroke can often be accomplished in a home garage for a couple hundred dollars, while similar work on a four-stroke might require specialized tools and significantly greater expense. This accessibility has historically made two-stroke dirt bikes crucial for introducing new generations to motorcycle sports. Their potential disappearance could substantially raise the barrier to entry, potentially reducing participation in motorsports among those with limited financial resources. Regional economies also experience ripple effects from regulatory changes affecting these engines. In areas where off-road riding contributes significantly to tourism and recreation economies, restrictions on two-stroke engines impact businesses ranging from motorcycle shops to hospitality services. When public lands implement two-stroke bans, communities often experience immediate declines in visitation, as many enthusiasts cannot afford to immediately replace their equipment with compliant alternatives. The two-stroke debate frequently descends into polarized positions, either advocating for unrestricted use or demanding complete prohibition. Yet the most sustainable path forward likely exists in a more nuanced middle ground that balances environmental protection with the preservation of motorcycling heritage and accessibility. A sophisticated approach recognizes that not all two-stroke applications create equal environmental impacts. Modern, technologically advanced two-stroke engines can offer surprising environmental advantages in certain contexts. Their manufacture typically requires fewer raw materials due to simpler construction. Their lighter weight means less material is needed, not just for the engine, but for the entire vehicle structure. End-of-life recycling processes are often more straightforward. Now, in some applications, with newer technology, they can achieve surprisingly good fuel efficiency, particularly when compared with larger displacement four-strokes needed to achieve similar performance. More refined regulatory frameworks might include grandfather provisions for existing engines, allowing continued operations of older machines while preventing new sales of high-emission models. Seasonal regulations could also permit usage during less environmentally vulnerable periods, such as winter months when the ground is frozen, or during drier seasons when watersheds face reduced risk. Designated usage areas could concentrate environmental impact in spaces specifically designed for motorsports rather than dispersing it across sensitive ecosystems. Incentive programs could also accelerate adoption of cleaner two-stroke technologies like direct injection and advanced electronic engine management. These approaches acknowledge that environmental impact varies dramatically by context. A two-stroke dirt bike used occasionally on a designated off-road track represents a fundamentally different environmental challenge than one used daily for commuting in an urban area with air quality concerns. Similarly, a direct injection two-stroke outboard used occasionally for recreation presents a different risk profile than a carbureted model operating daily in a watershed supplying drinking water. The question of whether two-stroke engines face outright prohibition misses the more nuanced reality. Their future will differ substantially from their past, shaped by both regulatory pressures and technological adaptation. On public roadways, conventional two-stroke motorcycles have largely vanished from countries with stringent emission standards, with little likelihood of returning in their traditional form. The era when manufacturers like Suzuki, Kawasaki, and Yamaha produced high-performance two-stroke street bikes exists primarily in the past, preserved through vintage collections and restorations. In marine applications, direct injection technology has allowed two-strokes to maintain relevance, though they increasingly compete with efficient four-stroke alternatives and emerging electric propulsion systems. The most promising future for two-stroke engines lies in specialized niches where their power-to-weight advantage, mechanical simplicity, and cost-effectiveness remain most valuable, and their environmental impact can be effectively managed. Competition off-road motorcycles represent one such category, where weight advantages translate directly into performance benefits that can outweigh emissions concerns, especially in controlled environments like closed courses. Snowmobiles operating in remote winter conditions represent another potential stronghold, as their use in cold, open areas during limited seasons mitigates certain environmental concerns. Small equipment like chainsaws and leaf blowers continue leveraging the compact power delivery of two-stroke designs, though increasingly these too face competition from battery-powered alternatives. Racing categories that prioritize power-to-weight ratio and simple field maintenance continue supporting two-stroke technology. Now, the broader context cannot be ignored. Internal combustion engines generally face mounting pressure from electrification across numerous applications. Yet circumstances remain where battery technology presents some significant limitations. In remote backcountry environments, where carrying additional fuel represents the only practical method to extend range, the lightweight efficiency of two-stroke engines might prove more enduring than heavier alternatives. When minimal weight is absolutely crucial, as in ultralight aircraft or certain racing disciplines, the two-stroke's fundamental advantages resist obsolescence. Forward-thinking manufacturers have begun developing hybrid systems that pair two-stroke engines with electric motors in complementary configurations. These designs aim to reduce emissions while preserving distinctive performance characteristics that enthusiasts value. Such hybrid approaches potentially represent transition technology, bridging conventional internal combustion and fully electric future scenarios. Enjoyed learning about two-stroke engines? Well, smash that like button and subscribe for more engine tech breakdowns. Hit that bell icon so you never miss our next deep dive into some controversial motorcycle tech.